Welcome once again to FTL. Today, I'm going to be playing with the, Rock Sea Ship. And I'm going to be chasing after this particular achievement. I already have it on normal, but I don't have it on hard. And I don't know, I don't really take that much stock in achievements, but I thought it might be fun to try and get this on camera. So I'm going to rename the ship, of course. And specific to this quest, I am going to rename the crewman. So sorry, Elaine, you are going to have to be the emissary. Ruin is obviously crystalline for emissary. That's probably not actually true, but whatever. In the meantime, I will also show off how to kind of get this ship going. It can be a little bit tricky to get started with, but you do have a rocket launcher. So let's just get into this. I'm not sure how instructive this will be, but who knows, might be useful to have some more footage. So, let's just quickly get in, get started. Okay. This one is diseased, so I cannot go for it. I'm probably gonna rearrange the weapons like this. It really depends on what kind of battle you get into, which is better, but usually it's like this. Alright, what have we got? Ooh, Zoltan shields. Alright, so this ship does not like Zoltan shields. As you probably, guessed, crystal weapons are really slow. And even though this does 2 damage, we really don't want to be relying upon that alone to break this. Especially since they're going to be pummeling us pretty shortly. Fortunately, they're probably not going to hurt us on the first volley, since this is 10 seconds and this is 10 seconds, and lasers are, as a rule, much faster than ions. So this laser should arrive first. So that'll actually buy us some time. That means I can charge up this swarm missile all the way, I think. Alright, like so. I'm just gonna let my shields go down. Okay, well, if it had hit anything else, then that would have been good. That missed, that's bad. Is this gonna come back up in time? I don't think it will. So now that it's just charged up all the way, I'll go ahead and fire that. Wow, mean. So yeah, I wanna fire this. Give this a chance to charge up a little bit. I don't think I want to fire it right away, because the spread on this is kind of frustratingly inconvenient here. I haven't crunched the actual numbers on this, but it feels like you only have a half chance of hitting this room, and that's before enemy evasion. So I pretty much, whenever I'm aiming at a 2x1 room, I almost always let this charge up to 2, sometimes 3. So let's just see what this hits first. That's going to be the important bit here. Looks like weapons. This is about to charge to 2, so I will go ahead and let my Crystal Heavy take the hit by rearranging my weapons. Let's see. So now it's going to be another 10 seconds, so is it worth waiting for another one? Probably. If I only hit once, I'm going to shut off the ion, probably, instead of the laser. So I think I can wait, you know, the full amount of time for this to charge up again. Is the missile gonna reach it before the laser? I think so. Even though we aren't manning, this is still, like, 7 seconds, I think, so I think it'll take less than 3 seconds to actually hit this. What's the ion hitting? Yeah, just that. Okay, so we have a shield now. That's good. So, yeah, look at that. That's, so, not exactly reliable against a room like this, but it's alright. I only shot, you know, one missile for that barrage, so it was okay. So, now we shouldn't need the swarm missiles as much. This ship I actually like the most out of, well, I don't know about that, but I like it a lot out of the, out of the three rock ships. I think this one has the easiest start of the three. It's kind of iffy, though. Really dependent upon the ships you run into. Okay, this could get a little bit bad. I'll go ahead and drop my shields and let this go through. Alright, good, good. Okay. So they are delayed. So I have the option right now of just shooting three missiles at this ship and pretty much guaranteed to take it out. 13 is a decent amount, but you do still want to be conservative with your ammo whenever you can. And since these guys are going to be busy for a while, I think I can wait long enough to just shoot a crystal heavy instead of waiting the whole time. They might fix this, but I think I should be okay. Yeah, alright. So he saved a missile by doing that. Alright, so he faced a Zoltan shield ship, and we only took 2 damage. Which was actually a little bit unlucky, because we wouldn't have taken that much damage if they hadn't, in succession, hit this with an ion and then shot it with a laser. So, that was alright. I mean, they didn't have a burst 2 or anything like that. Anyway. Once again, I will hit half a shield here to make us more protected from exactly that kind of thing happening. So let's try and get into some other fights, get some more examples of how to fight with this loadout. Okay. You should be even more pathetic than the other one. So these are timed well, but we might... So again, here's an option. We can shoot a single missile at this if we want, but they're not really that scary. If they had like a burst 2 and like a mini beam, I'd probably consider doing that, but I'm just gonna go ahead and save my missile for now. Besides, this might even miss. Okay, that's not good. But, we should be alright. I guess in theory, you could, take down the shield to let the laser in and then raise it in time for the mini-beam. But that seems really iffy. The timing on that is pretty specific, I think. Alright, so even without manning the shields, that was good on the second volley, because they were not manning their weapons, I think. That is good to know. So I'm gonna take him down, though. So again, we probably won't need our swarm missiles anymore, but I'm gonna keep them online just in case. In fact, let's see if I can go for a breach here. No such luck. Even though this is a heavy crystal, I find that breaches on this weapon just don't happen very often at all. You need to get really lucky for that to actually happen. Still, though, if the enemy ship can't hurt you, it's still usually worth a try. Because if you can breach their oxygen, they're usually in pretty bad shape. Alright, good. This is tempting. I like level 2 piloting early in the game, but it would involve putting off level 2 shields, so I don't think I can take advantage of this. Sorry, guys. Sure, we've got fuel. Okay. This will make us so much more safe. So much safer. Alright. So now, these guys have a much less chance of actually being able to hurt me. Right. You go down here, and you go up there. Thank you. Alright. So these guys should be pretty much on the ropes now. Nothing to really do to speed that up. Alright, I was lucky. This is tempting. It's on ships like this that you really have to consider offers like this. 10 scrap is not bad for Sector 1. Like, if we take this, then that means, there's a lot of other surrenders we can just refuse to take. And this was just an average pirate, I don't think they were chasing anybody. So, it's tempting, but I don't know, it's like, how much more scrap could I even get? It would be like 15 scrap. So, yeah, I think this is good enough. Alright. So, I'll go ahead and buy one of these. Because that way we can have even more effective shields plus evasion. Next, I'll probably buy engines 3 and then another power. Okay. You're a bit of a tough customer, but we should be mostly alright. This is going to arrive first. I don't think manning engines is going to do anything anyway, so you might as well man shields. And then, is it worth? Yeah, we just bought a whole bunch of missiles, so alright, let's try it. Alright, worth a try. In theory, this ship should be slightly better against flak than some other ships just because of these thin sections. A lot of empty holes on the ship, but in practice it doesn't really matter all that much. Let's see, I think I breached that, so it's probably worth trying to breach this too. Let's go ahead and go over to the scanners and see what the crew looks like. Alright, two humans who are just, alright, very good, very good. So I think, yeah, we'd have to, like, we would have to damage this and breach this, I think. So unless we can, like, basically, it's going to depend upon whether this breaches or not, whether it can get the crew kill. It doesn't. So, like, we would have... Yeah, this guy is at, like, too much health. So, yeah, we're not going to be able to get the crew kill on this one. That's too bad. Unless they're at, like, less than... No, see, I thought maybe... No, there's no reason for them to be in the clone bank. So, yeah, nothing we can do about it. Okay, so that resisted, so... Alright, well, this is worth one missile. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna pretend that this is a level 1 clone bay. It's a level 2 clone bay, it doesn't matter. But I'm gonna let this fire one missile. And, now I'm gonna turn it off. Oh. Wow, that was close. But if I'd been slightly faster, I would have gotten the crew killed there. But you understand the principle now, so now we'll just, blow up this ship. Wow, come on guys, we gotta finish this up. I've got another beacon to be at. Chop chop. Let's see, could I hit... Yeah, I think I could hit both of these. So on average, especially since I don't have my piloting upgrade yet, I think I'd prefer to just hit two regular beacons as opposed to one. How could I hit three of these, actually? I could hit this, then it would be like that. So it would look like this, and then I think I could hit two nebulas. Alright, I'll go up here then. If it was a choice between two regulars and one regular and one nebula, then I'd go with two regulars, but I'd prefer one regular and two nebulae to either of those previous options. Do I have time? So this is like risking all the nebulae beacons to turn this into a fight. And most of the time this is either just not a fight or it's a fight anyway, so yeah, I'll go ahead and try it. Alright, worth a try, I think. So yeah, I'll go up here and then here, and maybe if I have time I'll go here. Sure thing. Oh. Well, I'm glad I have the extra shields for this one. I think manning the... Usually this enemy ship has two crew, so they're not going to be manning their weapons. So I think manning these shields might actually make a difference here. I'm going to try it. Since my dodge is not very good right now, anyway. I think... Alright. Okay, I was right. Good, good. So now these should be desynchronized a little bit. This should fire a lot faster on the second volley than this one should. So I might not even need my swarm missiles. And I'm a bit too lazy to do the math for these later volleys, so I might take some more damage, but we'll see. Is it worth... let's see, now this is gonna go first, yeah, I'm getting a little bored. Alright. Alright, very good. Oh, that's too bad. So we finally got our breach in the oxygen, but they're gonna escape soon unless I, like, also breach the, piloting. So I'll go ahead and try for that, but, yeah, they've already got this route repaired, so it's probably not worth trying to crew kill these guys. That's not all that good. Either more fuel or more missiles would make this better, but this is pretty low amounts of everything. 3 fuel's not bad, but it's still pretty terrible. Oh, what am I doing? Well, it's too late for that to matter, so... Okay. Game was taking pity on me. I could have taken a damage there. Yeah, they already fixed that breach, so... Yeah. Okay, if I had been smarter, I wouldn't have taken that damage, so I guess it evened out. I was careless both times. So yeah, if I go here, then they'll be here, and then if I go here, they'll be here, I think. No, I don't have time for that, because it'll be, taken over. I have to go here and then here, which is fine, that's what I expected. Alright, this is probably not a problem. Let's see, if they charge up one, that's not a problem at all, so I'll have one shield. If they charge up two, that's not a problem. If they charge up three, this will already have fired, so I think I should just ignore that. I don't think I need to spend a swarm missile here. Still worth trying to dodge these, though. I just have to remember to actually use my second shield if they get this online somehow. Let's see. They could, repair that pretty quickly, so I'm just gonna go ahead and go for the, certain kill here. It was an entire, volley before that was gonna get online again. Let's see. Yeah, one more power would be fine. Cell missiles. This can be a very big, this can be a big kickstart at the start of the game, having 45 scrap all of a sudden. But you really do need these missiles in the early game, especially with this ship. Like, if we run into a two-shielded ship in Sector 2, we're going to need these, and we would be very happy to still have 15. I think since we're getting a decent amount of missiles so far, we're okay with selling 5, but I wouldn't sell any more than that. 15 is a good number to have. Okay, so that was a pretty good Sector 1. We got our 2 shields and we got our 3 engines. And we could buy level 2 piloting if we wanted to, but I'm gonna wait until the next sector. But that's normally about the amount of scrap you want. It's 2 shields, 3 engines, and maybe level 2 piloting, or maybe like a weapons upgrade or something like that. But that's about the best you can hope for in this sector. Let's see. This is kind of a toss-up. These are going to be pretty much about the same. Mantis might board me, and Rock might have missiles, but it's going to be about the same either way. I'm just going to go with Mantis control, just because Rocks can resist sometimes, and I think, yeah, Mantis never have flak 1, and Rock can have flak 1, so I'm going to go here. Okay, nothing of note. Oh yeah, rock sectors have a lot of hazards in them, like suns and asteroid fields, where you have some of those, but a lot less of those in Mantis sectors too, so that's also worth considering. So with that in mind, I think I'm just gonna go ahead and buy the level 2 piloting now. It's still gonna be a little while before we get another weapon. We're gonna try and get a weapon by the tail end of this sector, or maybe middle of Sector 3. That's usually a good benchmark on hard mode. But we should be fine with our current weaponry for the time being. We just need to boost our defenses up a little bit. So of course we'll attack the rebels. Here is definitely a case where I think it would be worthwhile shooting a swarm missile. I don't think we're gonna be able to take this missile launcher down, but it'll help us destroy their weapons once the crystal actually fires. And in the meantime, it'll slow them down a bit. Yeah, like I thought, that might have been an Artemis missile, but that's okay. I think that's weapons. So, yeah, this is about to fire, so I'm gonna leave it like that. That's rude. I'm gonna open the doors to make sure that this doesn't drain out as fast. It's also pretty rude. By the time we get this online, they're gonna have this fixed anyway, so it's not worth swapping over the swarm missile once I get this breach fixed. So we're gonna take some damage here. Let's see. I think this ship has rock plating, so yeah, we just didn't take any hull damage from that. So that's okay, I guess. That missed. Wow. 1 in 100 chance, folks. Okay, finally got that offline. What's this hitting? Alright, that's okay. I'm not gonna fire this yet. We might be able to keep the pressure on them with just the Crystal Heavy. Especially now that I'm manning the weapons again. Yeah, this is nasty enough that I'm gonna go ahead and fire all 3 of these. Piloting, engines, piloting. Man, maybe these guys do have level 3 engines. I guess it's possible. Or maybe they just have level 1 engines and they're getting really darn lucky. There we go. Yeah, we're no longer in any hurry, so we'll go ahead and fix this now. Technically, I guess I should have had the pilot do this, but whatever. That's okay. Alright. So again, got a little bit unlucky there. If it had been Artemis to anything else, even an Artemis to shields, we would have been okay. But Artemis is the weapon, one of the worst things that can happen to you in the early game. We're doing fine on hull, so I'll go ahead and steal these. Very nice. Best reward. You get a little bit of scrap, and you get drone parts, depending upon what sector you're in. So, very nice, very nice. Look, you guys are just going to have to do without. You're going to have to find different suppliers, because this is a war. And, you know, we're preventing the later subjugation of your folks by the rebels. You're just going to have to make friends elsewhere. Maybe you can ask the NG or the Federation for help. But these are dangerous times, and we need all the stuff we can get. So we're going to steal your stuff. Let's see, I already got that, so now's the time when I'm debating whether or not to get the fourth engine level or get a weapon system buffer. Because if I spent 35 scrap, then that would go a long way towards keeping my weapons online when they get hit by missiles. But, you know, it doesn't help you dodge the missiles any better. So, But I mean, you know, sometimes the best offense, you know, keeping your offense online can be a good defense. That's what I'm trying to say. Anyway. I think it kind of evens out. I don't think it really matters all that much. Empty beacon. We're gonna need to hit a store soon if we can't find any ships to fight. But usually there's plenty of fights in this sector. Like this one. Hacking. Piloting. That's alright. In fact, they can't hurt us. So, let's see what they've got. They've already got two anti-drones, so they probably don't have anything else special. Maybe they have a system repair. Alright, that's what I thought. 3-1 power drones is a little bit unusual. So, basically, the only thing really worth considering is, like, are they gonna run away? Which could be a little annoying. But other than that, I don't see any reason to, you know, the only thing I can see to do is to just keep hitting piloting over and over again. So that way, if they try and run away, we can launch a swarm barrage. And hope we don't hit either of these anti-drones. Come to think of it, eventually we should kill the pilot. He's just gonna revive in the clone bay, but that should help momentarily. Alright, good. They're not running away yet, so after I hit them, I still have 2 health, so I should be able to follow that up immediately with this if I need to. Surrendering 5 fuel. Given the circumstances, I will go ahead and take this. 5 fuel, 8 missiles, that is, that's very nice. Let's see now. So, yeah, store could be anywhere. So, but we have fuel now, so we can just jump around and, farm this sector. Alright, so I think I'm kind of leaning a little bit more heavily towards, spending the 35 scrap on this, because there are so many good 2-power weapons that can go very well with the swarm missile, and it also gives us a damage buffer in case we want, like, crystal heavy, flak 1 damage buffer or something. Yeah, we'll even let your guy revive. So, yeah, I'm thinking this first, then maybe engines, or maybe save up for another weapon. I find that you kind of need a weapon pretty fast on this, because you don't want to keep using your swarm missiles. Like, I've been doing pretty well in just keeping it to 1 or 2 a battle, but once you get to 2 shield ships, you need something other than swarm missiles. So I think I'm just going to save my money for now. Okay. Shouldn't be a big problem. Alright, so they've got the 2x2 room, so I will go ahead and spare 1 missile to try and get this offline. You can just hold on for a little while. Okay, that's kind of what I was afraid was going to happen, but it was worth it. Okay, that's strange. Everything I know about the AI tells me that they should have either shut off that missile immediately, or just left this offline and, like, just left this offline and then fired the missile. So I don't get it. I don't understand why they did that. I don't know. AI can be pretty weird sometimes. I think you need backup. Yeah, you need backup. You're actually doing pretty well in there, but you still need backup. So it can be pretty satisfying to basically have your own flagship triple missile launcher, but it definitely has its own drawbacks, that's for sure. Another nice thing about, well, okay, this isn't particular to Mantis in particular. Yeah, I think they might fire that before this charges up, so I'll go ahead and do this. Being a little bit wasteful on missiles, but that's okay. Got one of them back. Wow. Okay, thanks, game. You guys... let's see. Yeah, this is a Mantis sector. I will go ahead and get some new crew here. They're gonna lose some skills, but I'd prefer for them to just be at full health. So, the thing is, I love the Halvard beam, but beams and crystal weapons do not get along at all. So, I may actually wind up selling the Halberd beam. But it'll be nice to have in the meantime. Especially since enemy ships still usually only have one shield. So, that is certainly worth getting in. Particularly, the nice thing about this is that it doesn't miss. So this will be a great way to do one damage to a lot of different systems. At least while we still have it. Yeah, we need 25 now. Okay. So, I mean, I'm certainly not gonna turn up my nose at this, but it's certainly nothing like getting a, like, even I think a Burst Laser 1 would be better than this at this point. Because Burst Laser 1 and Crystal Heavy gives me options. This is still gonna peter out after a while. Might as well go to Distress Beacon, though. Got answers for some distresses. Not all of them, but some of them. This is risky as all, a lot of stuff. We are not near a store, we just jumped to the edge of the sector, so I do not feel comfortable doing this. Yeah, we definitely could have run out of fuel if we did that. Sorry, guys. Hopefully you can ask the Rebels for some. Okay. So they've got a bomb. That means I will go ahead and order the weapons like this, because most of the time this is a small bomb. Sometimes it's a stun bomb or a fire bomb, but usually it's a small bomb, and in that case, I want to still have a weapon online after I take 2 damage. Other than that, these guys should not be scary at all. Should be able to just handle them in the same way. I'm not even bothering to use my lockdown power right now. I'll think of some way to use it later, but right now it's just not necessary. Alright, so it was a stun bomb. So I might have reordered the weapons, but it should be okay. Let's see, I think I'm gonna try for a breach on the medbay. I think I stunned a person in there, that's why that door is being held open. But no breach. So, yeah, I don't think I'm gonna get the crew kill. Okay, now I've got fuel. That's how this early game tends to work sometimes, is you just kind of coast along at 5 or 6 fuel for a while. Let's see, yeah, we could definitely use one more power. We could save our money instead. How much does this sell for again? I think it's like 37 or something, so just a little bit more, and then we'd be able to sell this by a Burst Laser 2. That would be pretty, pretty good, I'd say. We also have this rock plating to sell. We, like, this is there's been a lot of analysis on the forums about how good this is. I still maintain that the main use of this is to sell it for 40 scrap. Sometimes you can keep it until you get a free weapon from the first phase of the crystal quest, and then sell it. But we just went to a mantis sector instead of a rock sector, so maybe I should have gone to the rock sector instead to try and look for it. I don't think it's really worth worrying about. So basically we've got 77 scraps, so we've got like an imaginary amount of 128, so I think I can go ahead and spend, this much for now. Wow. I mean, I guess you guys have, like, a better med bay or a better teleporter or something, so you'd be able to crew kill a civilian shuttle pretty easily, but... I mean, come on, guys, this is just pathetic. We fought tougher ships in Sector 1. Okay, hold on. There we go. Much, much better. I'm gonna go ahead and hit that too. Nah, it isn't worth using the halberd beam just yet. Okay, that's one down. Hopefully I can get a breach on the med bay. That'll make this a lot easier. Alright, like I thought, they had three crew. One of them is an NG, one of them is a mantis. Okay, good. They got the mantis repairing the med bay. So, yeah, unless this breaches, we're probably not going to be able to get it. Yeah, no good. We'll just cut them apart instead. So let's see. Yeah, Mantis, I think Rock Sectors might have more stores than Mantis Sectors, or maybe they just both have, like, one or two. I forget exactly. All I know is that Green Sectors usually have more stores than Red Sectors. So let's see, just taking a look at the sector map here. I think we can go, like, 1, 2, 3 or something. So I think I go here, because this gets taken over pretty fast. Okay, this might be taken over. We should still have enough flexibility, though. Okay, you should be no problem, I hope. Let's wait for this bomb to go off first. It's taking a long time, so it's either a stun bomb or a nylon bomb. It is not a bomb. That is what kind of bomb it is. See that? He just got a bit of a kill there, so killed him just before he teleported away. Okay. Okay, so this is not taken over. This might be taken over, but yeah, this is better. Like, this is guaranteed to be something. This might be an empty beacon. I mean, this might be an empty beacon too, but we'll see. Alright, let's send the endless wave of clones of our crew to help. Oh no, Ruin died. Oh, okay, I guess we're alright. I guess we can still get that crystal quest after all. So yeah, now I can go here and here. Getting really low on fuel, though. So do I want, like... So, like, if I jump here and then jump out, I'll have one fuel. If I jump here, then jump here, then jump out, I'll have zero. Unless, like, I get fuel at either of these two beacons, which is probably fair. I think I'd rather take the chance now than take the chance at the next sector. Because I think we still had a decent number of empty beacons over here. So the chances are this should be good, and then this neutral event might get us fuel somehow, too. We'll see. But I'd rather take the chance now than take it later. So with that in mind, do I spend scrap now? What would I buy? I would buy level 4 engines. What would that do for us? In the case where I run out of fuel, I also probably don't get any more scrap, so 14 is not a good number. You want at least like 20 on hand, in case you need to buy fuel for scrap. So, not gonna spend anything. Wow, thanks guys. Thanks for the scrap, that is. Alright, do you have fuel? I need reactor supplies. I've got 26 missiles, and I'm not even using drones yet. I am a little bit scared of trading away drones, because I might need to buy hacking. Hacking would actually be perfectly fine, because of crystal heavy and halberd beam and hacking would be awesome, actually. 7 drone parts would still be enough for that, so, yeah, alright. Kind of ticked off that we don't have fuel, so we're gonna have to wait at the start of this next sector, but, that's okay. So, then, all things being equal, I'd rather be waiting at the start of a nebula sector so that it takes longer for the rebels to catch up. So, I guess we'll see what happens. This is, a little scary.